One of the keys to getting pregnant naturally is making sure that you have sex close to the time of ovulation. There are many different ways to figure out when ovulation is going to happen. For example, in this playlist, I talk about using apps and home ovulation tests. What about using the changes that occur in the cervical mucus to time when to have sex? Does that really work? What is cervical mucus? What is a cervix? And most importantly, what is the correct way to spell cervical mucus? I wouldn't be YouTube's most popular and trusted fertility expert unless I can answer the really tough questions, so stay tuned. This is a uterus. If you are a couple who is trying to conceive naturally, then one of you needs to have one of these. The uterus is connected to the vagina. When a couple has sex, sperm are released into the vagina and must then travel through this opening to make it into the uterus. This is known as the cervix. The cervical canal is like a long tunnel connecting the vagina with the inside of the uterus. The walls of this tunnel, however, are not smooth and straight. There are many twists and turns and folds and ridges. The cells in these folds and ridges produce a gel-like substance which is called cervical mucus. Cervical mucus is 90 to 95% water mixed with some proteins which are attached to molecules of sugar. In a person who ovulates, as the egg matures, the cells around it produce estrogen. This estrogen causes changes in the composition of the cervical mucus. Early in the cycle, long before ovulation, the estrogen levels are low and the cervical mucus is thick and white. This helps prevent bacteria from getting into the uterus. It also prevents sperm from getting into the uterus. As the egg matures, the estrogen levels increase and the cervical mucus becomes clearer, thinner, slippery, and stretchy. In fact, it is very similar to a raw egg white. This makes it easier for sperm to get into the uterus at the time of intercourse. It is easy to check the consistency of the cervical mucus because it drips into the vagina. The vaginal discharge is mostly from the cervical mucus. To check the mucus, put a finger into the vagina, pull it out, and press your finger against your thumb. Then separate your finger and thumb. Here is an important point to know. Clear, thin cervical mucus is not a sign of ovulation. It is a sign that estrogen levels have increased. In a person who is ovulating, high estrogen levels usually occur right before ovulation, so it is a reasonably good indicator that you are close to ovulation. This is what fertility doctors refer to as the fertile window. This study determined that couples who had sex on the days when the cervical mucus was slippery and clear had a better chance for getting pregnant on that month because they were likely to be having intercourse close to the time of ovulation. Slippery, clear cervical mucus can occur 5 or 6 days before ovulation. However, pregnancy can occur even if the cervical mucus is not slippery and clear. In some women, cervical mucus might not be that reliable. For example, overweight women produce higher estrogen levels, so they may have clear, slippery mucus all of the time. This is also true for women who are taking estrogen. If you are using a vaginal douche, cervical mucus may be thin and clear even when ovulation is not close. Some fertility medications like Clomid or letrozole can reduce the amount of cervical mucus even though ovulation is occurring. Cervical mucus is most reliable when it clearly changes from thick and white to thin, clear, and slippery, and then back again. If your cervical mucus exhibits those changes and you have sex while it is slippery and clear, then timing sex this way may work just as well as a home ovulation test. One final important point. Some con men will try to sell you supplements or treatments to improve your cervical mucus. Do not fall for this scam. Treatments like cough syrup do not improve your chances for getting pregnant. It is still possible to get pregnant even if the cervical mucus is not ideal. One more final point. The correct spelling is M-U-C-U-S. This is a noun. The other spelling, M-U-C-O-U-S, is an adjective used to describe something like mucous membranes. there you have it. You are now an expert in cervical mucus. Infertility TV is your most trusted source for accurate information on infertility and miscarriage. If you are not a subscriber yet, hit the subscribe button right now. A new episode is released every week. Don't miss any episodes. You can also check us out on our website, ivf1.com, where you can become a patient.